In the name of Jesus, amen. The first king of Israel would never have needed a sign over his head at any time saying, "This is Saul, king of the Jews." You would have known it just by looking at him. He was a head taller than everyone else in Israel. He was handsome, strong, came from a wealthy family. You would have needed no more than one glance at his exalted head to declare, "Now there's a king." But Saul's was a story of an exalted head brought down, for he followed in the way of another king, the world's first king, Adam. And like Adam, he turned away from the word of the Lord. Therefore, God anointed a new king, a man after God's own heart, the young shepherd, David. But Saul persecuted and reviled the Lord's newly anointed. He was so jealous of David's popularity among the people that it sent him into a murderous rage. The mere presence of David so filled Saul's head with envy that he chased him around the countryside like a madman. His anger even caused him to try to pin David to the wall with a spear, but David evaded him. In the end, the once exalted head was cut off by the Philistines on Mount Gilboa, and he died in disgrace. Now consider the scene of Jesus, the greater David, as he is crucified and reviled on Golgotha. They mock God's king. What hatred is hurled against the Lord's anointed? The passers-by wag their heads at him and revile him. The envious chief priests, scribes, and elders don't like his popularity one bit. Rail at him to prove his kingship. Even two robbers direct their insults directly at Jesus' head. Consider the scene tonight and consider your guilt against the Lord's anointed. Haven't you too wagged your head and stood in judgment of the Lord, often judging him to be unfair? Consider how often you have turned from the Lord's word and demanded that he prove his love. What were you thinking when your bitterness drove you to insist that you deserve better, even though you are as guilty before God as any robber on the cross? Consider tonight your many resentful and angry thoughts toward God. Consider the judgment that should come down upon your head. But then consider the bloody and ugly king on the cross. Be glad. Consider the thoughts going on in his sacred head and be exceedingly glad. For his thoughts are not about getting revenge or pushing back the scorn onto the heads of sinners. His thoughts toward you are not filled with disgust. What's going on in the head of that king are thoughts love toward you, doing what is necessary to bear your scorn, to save you. The sign said, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." And that's good, because we would never have identified him as God's anointed. No one would ever have looked at Jesus and said, "Now there's the head of a king." He's the king you never wanted, nor thought you needed. Yet he came to save you. He was not handsome like Saul, had no beauty that we should desire him. He set aside his kingly might voluntarily to die in weakness and disgrace. He was rich, yet for sinners' sake he became poor, so that you, through his poverty, might become rich. Placed on the throne of the cross, he was unrecognizable as a king, but just perfect job of taking your sins away so that the Father might recognize you forever as Jesus' sacred head is silent as he bears the persecution, the insults, and the rage. That head lifted up high upon a cross now hangs down and is bloody, but it's a beautiful head to sinners who know that he bears the wrath as man's substitute. Take great comfort in all that is happening in this scene, for our crucified King is all about crowning you with glory and honor. So that means he must wear your anger at him like a crown. Jesus, your King, was all about lifting that burden of guilt from your shoulders. So he shouldered it all to the cross and destroyed it, so that you might be exalted as innocent, holy sons and daughters of God. Those ears on his head heard all the insults, all the bitterness, that your ears might tingle as you hear the word of absolution, the word of forgiveness. Your King, the Lord's anointed, persecuted, reviled, rejected, and killed, but raised again to anoint you in baptism and adorn you with regal garments of innocence. Your King, the Lord's anointed, willing to be hunted and chased all over Israel that you might be embraced Father's love. Saul may have launched his spear at David and missed, but divine love would not allow Jesus to evade the soldier's spear, for the King on the cross was dead. But from that King on the cross comes the gusher of life-giving water to fill the baptismal font that washes away all your sins. From that dead King on the cross comes the life-giving blood that fills the chalice that you drink, cleansing you from all sin and lifting up your head in triumph. Believe it for Jesus' sake. Amen. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in true faith to life everlasting.